Once upon a time, in a wild, wild world, there were two wolf brothers living in their home lair with their papa wolf. They lived in peace until hunters took their dad away. The wolf brothers wandered for days and nights, learning how to live on their own for the first time. That's when the big brother discovered that the little one was not an ordinary wolf, but a super wolf.
Yeah, he was kind
of decided
special.
To head south to the distant land of their ancestors. But the journey was long and dangerous. Still, the wolf brothers made new friends on the way. They learned more about the world, but danger seemed to always follow them. After a bad accident, they were separated. The big brother had been hurt, and the hunters finally captured him. They put him in a cage, but when he finally escaped, he went to search for his little brother. He soon found out that the little wolf had joined a coyote cult, and he would not leave them.
A coyote cult?
Suddenly, their mother showed up. After all that time, she said she came to help rescue him. They begged the coyote leader, but she would not release the little wolf. He was their idol. So the big brother had to kill her so they could escape.
And also burn down a building in the process.
The wolf brothers, now reunited, followed their rogue mother far into the desert. To her hideaway.
It's all Daniel's fault. We won't say that, but it's all Daniel's fault. I keyed. Yeah, we'll have to play this through again and make the other choices. Ooh. Are we in the Grand Canyon? Seven weeks after the events at Haven Point. I cannot speak. Oh, look at Scorpion. Not MK11 Scorpion. Actually, Dangerous Scorpion. I should say Mortal Kombat Scorpion. Not MK11, but yeah, you know what I mean. Are we really sleeping outside? Aw, little bro don't have his bullshit bowl cut anymore. That shit was hilarious. That haircut was ridiculous
hey.
On him.
Wake up, Sean. Dude, come on.
What? What time is it?
Get up. It's so beautiful. Check it out.
It is pretty.
So?
Yeah, okay. Good call. Wow. That's amazing.
That is pretty crazy.
I know.
And to think it's just a giant
ass. Is your eye okay?
Crack.
Yeah.
In the Earth's surface.
It just itches. It's okay, Nano.
I
promise.
Yeah. Okay.
How about my
love
cool,
you.
Awesome mohawk back?
No matter what happens, you hear me?
Yeah. I love you too. Ow! Ow! Ow!
Ow!
Diaz brothers. Always.
So what, did they ditch their mother?
Are you still having those bad dreams? You know, about Lisbeth?
No, I just... think about what happened.
Don't think too much. It was her or us, Inanno. No choice.
I know, dude. That was scary. She got what she deserved.
Manipulative little bitch.
Feel bad about it?
Yeah, but it had to be done.
Yes. I wish things were different. But we can't go back.
Good. I'm kind of glad she's dead. Sean. Are we criminals now?
We were criminals long ago. Sort of.
Sort of. We did a lot of illegal shit.
Well,
if the cops catch us,
Sean did most of the illegal shit.
We'll be judged for what we did. That's for sure.
Daniel basically just killed a cougar. Get us.
Well, we're almost at the border. Finally.
I like it here, but we'll have to leave soon. I know.
I'm sorry, Inanno.
Sean, I know it's been a long time. Can you tell me the rest of the wolf story?
Oh. Yeah, I can tell you.
The wolf story.
Been forever since we left off.
Way too long.
Well, maybe you weren't a little shit. No, I'm just
kidding. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Just kidding.
Thanks to their mama wolf, the wolf brothers barely escaped from the coyote cult. She led them to her secret lair deep in the Red Desert. The wolf brothers rested for a while, but at some point, they'd have to continue their journey south. They were closer than ever to their father's land, but between them and their destination lied
the evil chupacabra, and they would have to fight it together.
Sure, chupacabra.
Excuse me, who's telling the story?
You are, but it's my story too, right?
This is my version.
Yeah. That's true. Okay, then.
It is their story.
Okay. So the wolf brothers encounter the evil chupacabra.
Chupacabra.
And he attacks them. He's very dangerous.
You're not quite the storyteller.
But the little wolf uses his powers to crush him.
Well, as Sean is there,
they
Daniel.
Arrive in the magic land as heroes. Because they have defeated the beast.
Okay, Stephen King Jr. You win. Let's pack this shit up and head back to town. Gotta clean up our stuff before we leave.
Yeah, just fucking leave it there.
And this place is too pretty. I'm glad we had these. Not a fan of desert critters.
Well, of course we gotta draw. Can't go to the Grand Canyon and not at least take a picture of it.
Ooh, sketching time. Good
indeed.
Idea.
Indeed.
I'm glad you can still draw after. You know.
Me too, Daniel.
You fucking took my eye out?
But I can see it in my mind. I can still sketch anything. Almost.
That's so cool. I don't want you to stop drawing. Ever.
Thanks, man.
This is so cool. you draw me as a superhero? Like, striking a pose over the canyon.
I can try.
Badass, of course.
My back hurts a little. I'm glad we're sleeping in our bed tonight.
Ta-da. Finished.
Let me check it out. Oh, yeah. Now that's a badass superhero you don't want to mess with.
Telemoscope.
So incredible to see all those stars and planets up close. It's like we're right there.
Pack it up.
I hope we could go watch the stars again. Mom said there's a moon eclipse coming up soon.
I'm in. This place is cool. I could just move here. Activate flashlight.
On the way.
Talk about lazy. Jesus, just get off your ass and pick it up.
I swear Dad had that same book in the garage.
Yeah, I think he did.
Why did he never show it to us?
Maybe it reminded him of Mom too much.
Oh.
Possible.
Yeah, right.
Indeed. Let's clean up this mess.
Not if it cleans up by itself.
Stop. Daniel.
Can't catch it, huh?
No shit. Now cut it out.
Jeez. You're no fun.
Yo, Captain Can. Can you take these away?
Sure.
And no funny business.
Of course not.
Perfect formation. Well, let's hit the trail, cowboy.
We did good. Let's go see. You gonna leave your sleeping bags there?
What are you doing? What the fuck, dude? Don't do that.
What's wrong?
Stop messing with it, man.
What's the big deal? Look.
Seriously? What did you do that for?
Whatever. That thing could sting us to death.
So what? You just torture it? Jeez.
Dude, I didn't even kill it. I was just goofing around.
Let's just head out now.
That's fucked up, man. You don't torture an animal like that. I mean, he killed that fucking, what was it, cougar or mountain lion? Whatever the fuck it was supposed to be.
I wish we saw more falling stars. Or any.
Hey, we saw the Milky Way, dude. How cool is that?
Yeah, that's true. And Mars. That was so cool Arthur and Stanley let us use the telescope.
Yeah. These guys are real cool. Hey, see this? Looks like the ones you did back in that cabin. When you got sick.
Oh, totally. Wait, does that mean other people were here?
Of course. Maybe someone from away did it.
Oh, I bet it was Joanne. Think Joanne will let me help her with the sculpture when we get back?
Hell yeah.
Weed?
You're like the magic assistant.
Is that real weed?
Amazing that anything can grow out here.
Does it ever rain in the desert?
Well, oh, good question.
Anyway, what I was saying is, it's nice to be able to use my power out here. Not hide it.
Yeah, Karen was right. They're all cool with it.
Mom doesn't say much about my power. Why do you think?
She's confused.
Like, what do you mean? She's my mom.
Well, you know, I mean, she hasn't seen you for years. Not sure she can deal with all of this at the same time.
Huh. It must be weird for her.
I hear you. Hey, need help getting down?
Why don't you just float down?
I got this.
You'll float down, you little turd? Oh, come on, you should have did a Magneto.
Easy peasy.
Until you fall on your ass.
Yeah, but I didn't.
That is true, he did not.
Ooh, look, look. Oh, man.
Looks like a job for our local super psychic boy. Yeah, and you scared it.
I know.
Hey, D, you want to help us out here?
So, maybe you can help us get out of here?
I'll try. Step back.
Be super careful.
Nice.
Boom. Easy peasy.
Lemon squeezy.
Nice, man.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Oh, check it out, it's a little village. Life is Strange, the final chapter. Yeah.
Hey, I'm gonna go see what Joanne is doing.
Go for it. I have to bring back the telescope to Stanley and Arthur.
Hello?
Went to town for weekly supplies. Some pancakes left in the kitchen. Back soon.
Nice.
Daniel, you copy?
Yes, I read you. 10-4.
I have a pancake alert in the kitchen. Repeat. Pancake alert.
Whatever. Joanne has waffles. Over and out.
10-4.
Dude.
No flying pancakes today.
Not for nothing. Waffles are good, but I like pancakes better. Ooh, look at the crops.
Excuse me, water boy. Did you remember to feed the crops?
I never forget. Ask Mom. But no way I could grow stuff like she can. Maybe in Mexico.
Oh, yeah. We can grow a lot of stuff there. Still can't believe she's kept it. Dude. We could put red food coloring in the water and turn this into a blood tank.
Oh, yes. Then I could be Zomboy fighting vampires. Sucks that we can't get food coloring out here.
We could also try to be self-sufficient when we're in Mexico.
Whoa, we are, like, all up in his face. Solar panels.
Pretty smart. You're never gonna run out of sun in the desert.
Nope. For a little makeshift town. This is pretty bad.
Looking at this place, I see that Karen really wanted to get away from it all.
Yeah, right.
Literally. I hope the UFOs are listening. Hey, your Captain Spirit drawing was awesome.
Thanks. Wish I could show it.
Morning,
to Chris.
Sean.
Do you think he can visit us down in Puerto Lobos?
Pretty far away for a sleepover, right?
I know. I just can't wait for us to hang out again.
Morning, guys. Wish I could be as cool and as wise as these guys when I get older.
Fireworks.
Arthur and Stanley cannot wait for the 4th of July.
I'm gonna fucking take some of these motherfuckers.
Me neither. Dude, remember when you totally fell asleep during that Bollywood flick?
Because it was so lame after those cool cartoons.
Whatever. You missed Priya and Stanley teaching me how to dance.
No, I didn't. You can't dance, dude.
It's so cool that people want to give a second life to their stuff.
That is a pretty cool idea, a swap box.
We helped Joanne set up this giant vacuum with binoculars, as David calls it. I love how they recycle everything into art, construction, or agriculture here. What's up, Joanne?
See for yourself.
Man, check this out.
Okay, Daniel, let's take a little break.
Got it.
That child is something special.
Yeah. I hear this one a lot. Don't worry.
Yeah, I bet. I bet you have your own talent, Sean.
Pretty kick-ass drawer.
I'm dead serious.
I don't know.
Just doodles.
It's just doodles and shit. No big deal.
Yeah. I thought my sculptures were shit, too, compared to all the dope stuff that was being done. But every artist is fucking unique, Sean.
Indeed.
We all got something to bring to the world.
Did you always want to be an artist?
Good grief, no. I tried very hard not to be one. Till I realized it was useless.
Give in to the urge.
Listen, if you want to be an artist, you will be. It's not always easy. But in the end, it's pretty fucking cool. Speaking of, do you mind giving me a hand here?
I don't know if I can.
Yes, you can. I just need your input, okay?
Sure.
Okay. Sure. Why not?
Ah, there you go. Now, go stand over there. Daniel, you ready to start again?
Oh, yes. Hold on.
So, for my next trick, I'd love to see if you can connect these three pieces. I've made a model of what I have in mind here, but go ahead and be the artist. And we don't need a crane to lift this stuff. Daniel can snap these together like block toys.
Hell yeah. Let's do this.
All right, so what am I doing now? So that's the base, I'm assuming. So we need what, the belly? Yeah, the belly. What would be the belly? The belly.
Okay, Daniel. Can you slam dunk the earth ball onto the base?
Watch this layup. Oh, do like the model, but with the spider on top.
No, we stick treats.
Now, let's throw on that spider.
You got it.
Stick true to the original design that she wanted.
Now, let's move Mr. Pancake's head onto the pedestal.
There he goes!
Kind of looks like a Mr. Handy from Fallout.
Feel like we're almost done.
Well, I think this is it. Looks good to me.
Only if the muse approves.
Not what I had in mind, but it's still cool.
You did a great job, Inanna.
Well, Sean, Daniel, I think art might be in your family DNA. There's no escape. I think we're done for the day. Thank you so much for your help.
Okay.
That was fun. Joanne is so chill about her art.
I'm stuck on something that's what not makes there. Her
I bet you would like Minecraft. It's kind of like this.
Yeah, I've read about it. It's a video game, right?
Yes, and you can build whatever you want in it.
Ooh, you have to show me then.
No, thank
Karen
you.
Karen and Joanne spend evenings playing and chatting. Kind of like me and Lila.
No.
Back in the day.
Poor Lila. I miss Lila. Let's ponder our thoughts.
Bad habits.
This place is such a trip. It's kind of like a desert mirage. You think you can see it, but the closer you get, it changes. I thought the people here would be like freaks. But they're just sick of the bullshit. Now I sound like a local. I guess I'm always gonna be a visitor.
Jesus Christ, the camera angle always comes back a little weird. What's up, guys? Thank you for the telescope.
Hey, what's up?
Morning, Sean.
Join us.
Have a seat. Hey, just in time for our special desert brew. And dust free.
Thanks.
That's always good.
So much.
Sean, it's too early to be so awake.
No kidding. Hey, how was your sleepover in the canyon?
Amazing. We watched the sunrise. Daniel loved it too.
That's my favorite view out here. It's like ancient times, but it never gets old.
Unlike us, darling. That canyon will be here long after we're gone. Hope you looked up.
We did. Thanks for hooking us up.
Anytime. Even my daughter Becky loves to stargaze when she visits us.
That's the only way to get Arthur to camp now. Becky is the real astronomer in the family. Wonder where she got this.
From her mom.
Hey, Lashy Dashy, how you doing?
You guys get to meet
Welcome
Becky.
To the stream. I don't know if Harsh is in here. I don't think he is. If he is, he's lurking.
Does she come visiting often?
Not as much as I'd want.
No,
can't really
I
blame her.
But don't
you
go
know,
anywhere near that
well,
crap.
Some parts of the year, this place is full of friends and family.
I do not play that
Christmas,
kind of
for
game.
Example.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of Battle Royals. They're kind of played out now.
So, why did you come out here?
Honest fact,
because
there's too many hackers and cheaters in those games anymore.
Things change. But being gay is still dangerous. The end.
Sean, I'm almost 60, and I was a happily married man for 20 years until I came out. I don't blame my family for being in shock, but I didn't think they'd disown me. My other daughters won't even talk to me anymore.
Well, that's a shame.
So why stay?
He's got a point.
After we got together, we both had serious breakdowns. Then we got the hell out of the Bay Area. For the better.
I hear that. I'm just so fucking tired of running. I hope me and Daniel find our own way.
You will. People come here to reset their life. Become the person they wanna be. Or used to be. You're smart. You'll figure out your next direction. Right, Gramps?
Speak for yourself, Grandpa. My body might be 59, but I'm 25.
Uh-huh. I'll remember that on the next hike.
I'm gonna hang around before it gets too hot. Thanks for the desert brew.
We gotta give them their telescope.
These two remind me of Claire and Steven.
Did we get
in a weird hippie version?
Oh yeah, there it is right there.
Hey, Sean. What were you doing at Arthur and Stanley's place?
You're a little too young to be stalking me, dude.
You know what? I saw them kissing the other day. Kinda weird.
You know it's actually normal for people in love to kiss, right?
I know. I just mean, they're really cute together. I hope somebody cares about me like that when I get old.
Karen did help us a lot since she found me and Daniel. Better late than never.
Indeed.
Karen doesn't even like to leave this place just to go shopping. Looks like they all finally found their home. Karen looks so young and fragile on this picture.
Maggie and Karen. Summer
hard times.
2011.
Karen must have been so excited to finally hit New York.
Fly by night, not by freight, into the big city, bright stop. The cliche never dying in the steel of the buildings. The rap of the streets, but no matter what or where I spin, the pool of a million dead poets, take me to dance once again. Go! But this time, I get to lead until the next flight. Interesting.
She's really good at rewriting her own life.
Am I solo mobus strip? Just when I reach the end, I go back to the beginning. Resign myself to new faces, the privileges to escape, and rewrite another draft. Goddess laughs at plans, then shows me the page left unmarked for years. Out of the ghost desert, the seeds return as saplings to reveal their age and power. Now I go back forward, layered with fear and hope, to water the children of the sun.
This one's pretty intense.
Don't believe.
I think I get it.
Would find a soul within or without a church. A miracle with sleep and food and fuck. Okay, that's a weird one. A day without shit until it was not. Now we run celestial spires. Oh, vision of fake prophet. Engulfed in ego and belief as the burning cross falls on your cruel angels. I am the bonfire of vanities, so when the dam breaks, we all flood. Like glass on a mirage, if I believe. Deep, man.
Whoa. I hope Karen sends this to Claire and Steven.
Holy shit. That's a lot. Hi, Mom and Dad. I've been thinking about this letter for a while, and I know how long. I know it's been a long, long time coming, so I'm sitting here tonight thinking about the words I should have written 10 years ago.
You always used to say everything happens for a reason. We fight about it then, I understand why. Now, there is a reason I feel like I have to reach out to you both tonight from the desert. I know you've only heard from me once by phone and 6 times by letter, almost a decade. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt you, and I was certainly not trying to punish you, like you told me. Don't laugh, but I just didn't know what to say or write. Poet's block. Just like how you had to block me from your life after I left Esteban. I understand that was how you had to deal with a problem child, an only child who didn't live up to your expectations. There's no denying that I failed you, but the burden scratched out weight of your aspirations as parents failed me too. You had such a rigid opinion of what I was supposed to be that I just didn't have the chance, strike it, opportunity to explore who I actually was. You wanted a daughter to grow up happy, find a good job, and a great husband, settle down to breed. I love the strikeouts she has here. Have kids and raise them in faith to continue the cycle of suburbia. That daughter wasn't me. Well, I know that you were raised in a different time and culture, so I didn't understand your point of view like you didn't understand your wayward daughter. Maybe a bridge too far for us at the time. After Danny was born, you knew I wanted to take a break, some time to figure things out in my head and heart. I didn't make sense to you or Dad, and I get that, but you didn't see how. I was so desperate, and only Esteban was willing to give me that time because he saw how unhappy I was. I don't blame you for my decision and to leave. And maybe a timeout would have led to some outcome. To the same outcome. We will never know, and I try not to live in regret. My life has been a roller coaster, and there have been times I longed to hear your voices and thoughts, even the negative ones. And I know when I last talked to you in New York to ask for help in paying back my debts, you wanted to help, but it was you. It was on your condition to return right back to where I couldn't return. I hate that was our last conversation, and I am sorry I reached out to you this day. I'm sorry I broke your hearts. I'm sorry I let you break mine for silence for so long. For silencing me for so long. I think we paid our dues, and now I sit under the blue field of crystal stars like the poet. I hope I am writing and waiting for a chance to rebuild an old bridge with my mother and father. I hope we can cross it one more time. Love, your daughter. Aww. She feels sorry. She realizes she messed up.
Karen has been camping in her own house since we arrived. So good to have a home. Again. And a real bed.
Ooh, Cassidy's letter.
Didn't realize how much I miss Cassidy's voice.
Do we?
And her songs.
Hola, and sexy boy.
Dude.
No more city boy. Jake hooked me up with your P.O. box, so now you can't hide from your old crew anymore. I know you took off from the hospital, and I'm glad that you're still going down to Mexico. We've all been fugitives on the run, but you and Daniel are the kings of the road. I hope you finally get back home. Of course, I'm not ready to settle yet, so we're all hanging out in Colorado. The idea is trying to get as far away west coast as possible. To Magos. For now, hard to believe Finn isn't here to start shit. We don't miss him for that. But he'll get a few more songs out of me. We all want to remember him for his angels, not his demons. I miss you. I would love to take a road trip out of this shithole, and it would be great to swim with you again. So you better let me know when you hit Mexico, Sean. Don't make me track you down. Here, I'll even give you my number, so no excuses. Love, Cassidy. Oh shit! He got the digits! He got the digits. He got the digits. Oh, VHS tape, look at that.
Dad was an absolute fan of this movie.
Does that say Chupacabras from outer
Maybe
space?
Maybe they were nerds together.
Snake.
Wish Karen didn't tell me she got a rattlesnake out of the toilet last week.
Ho ho. Gotta watch out for that shit.
Gotta keep my eye lube handy.
Giggity.
Glad I don't need it as much.
That sounds so dirty. Let's check the interwebs.
Brody's so good at describing painful situations.
Brody.
And seeing the good into it. We miss you too, Lila. Always.
My birthday baby bro, Daniel Diaz, missing, not forgotten. I'll make a wish for you. Aww. What's Karen getting into?
Had no clue there was a network of seed pirates.
What the fuck? Really?
Karen's a real-life hacker.
That's funny.
Karen takes on some small pieceworks for a living.
Hey, Karen, thanks for your...
Must pay better than poetry.
Nice advice column. We got quite the response and a lot of hits. I know you don't want a social media footprint, but you could generate a lot of clicks with your insight. Looking forward to your next piece. Please make sure you... Make sure to send your invoice for May and June. Best, Alan. Aaron Queen, Managing Editor, Desert Life Weekly. Alright.
Daniel's Big Ten late birthday party.
Oh,
made
shit.
Made him feel so happy.
Better late than never. Alright, let's eat some pancakes.
One thing Claire and Karen have in common. Their love for pancakes.
Yeah, man. That was a big pancake. You fucking ate that shit with two hands. Okay, what's on the USB? The USB key.
Whoa. I should have gone through that flash drive weeks ago. Hey, Dad.
It's Teddy.
Lila always knew how to crack me up. Four. Okay. You're on it, Anno.
Yes. Thanks, Sean. Listen carefully. You must find the two items that will reveal where the treasure is.
Deal.
So for the first item is near the place with many wings that cannot fly.
What?
That's it.
That's your clue?
That's
your
it. Mm-hmm.
Ahoy, matey. I found a map of a way.
Yeah. Don't lose it because you'll need it to match up with the other part.
Got it.
Now, for the second item, you'll need to find something that eats the sun.
Uh-huh. Sure.
The solar panels.
Now that's some real patriots.
Hell yeah, why not?
You're warming up.
Huh. You think they picked this up at the gas station?
I hope not. It's too cute. Looks like Brody, the bear.
I sure wish we had him around now. He was a good guy.
Getting closer. Not too far.
See? Solar panel, told you.
Oh man, you're right there. Just look around.
Okay, the card pile.
Found it. Nice. And it's a tracing paper sheet with a red cross. Ahoy, matey. I think I have the whole treasure map.
Aye, Captain. Now you just gotta dig your way to the treasure.
Really?
Hope I gotta you know dig? Where to go.
That's a cool-ass map you drew, dude.
Thanks. Chris told me everything about treasure hunting.
Guess people came here with these and never left. You know I'm not Mr. Map Reader, so throw me a bone.
Oh, you are so weak. You can find this so easy, or I can just tell you where it is.
Fine. I see how you are. I don't need any more help.
Nope. As cold as ever.
Okay, so how do I dig?
It's close, Sean. You're warm. Oh man, you're right there. Just look around.
20 minutes later.
Oh, there it is. Oh, that's why I couldn't find
it. It's close, Sean.
Why the fuck were you saying it was close when I was over there?
Ooh, looks like something's buried here.
Fucking bullshit. Like, nowhere fucking
yes.
Near it.
I think I have found a hidden treasure.
Yeah, I knew you could do it. I found this under an old trailer. Looks like gold, right?
I'm not a prospector, but it looks like the real deal.
Yeah, just bite it. If it bends to your teeth, it's real gold.
Victory! Dance time! Come on, dance!
Dude, that is whiter than me.
Yeah!
Yeah, that dancing is definitely whiter than me.
You asked for it.
Probably about 50 minutes worth?
Oh, I think you're spotting Mom's truck coming back. Yes, 100% her.
Gotcha. We'll help her out with the groceries.
Okay, so where the fuck is she?
Hey, do you miss Beaver Creek?
I miss having a house. But the town was kind of dead. But I really miss Chris. And Grandma and Grandpa. I'm just glad we still have family out there.
Hey.
Hey, what's up?
Glad to see you survived the night in the desert.
Good morning.
Howdy, Sean.
How was the town trip?
Hate these trips. People look at us as if we're aliens. Here come the sand people.
The deserters have returned with
nothing
offerings
with
from Das Kapital.
Jolie! Oh, I missed you. Next time, you're coming with us.
We'll see.
Looking good. What's your secret?
Defying death on a daily basis. And hydrating.
Oh, right. Can't forget your goodies.
Hey, thanks, Angel.
Here.
You're the man, Karen. Catch you later.
Take care. Hey, so how did you guys like your night in the canyon?
It was amazing.
It was amazing. So many stars. So quiet. Good call, Karen.
I knew you'd like it, Stargazer. Glad you got to see that.
Hi, Mom. How was the town?
Town life always sucks. But we got something for you. Think fast.
Whoa, yes! Thanks, David.
You want to play catch, Danny boy?
Totally. Me and Dad always used to play, but I'm way better now.
No matter what he's been through, he just wants to be a kid and play.
So yep. Kids should
Daniel
do.
Hasn't been like this in forever. You've all been a good influence on him.
About time you boys went camping. Hope Daniel didn't get scared by all the critters.
Nah, been a while since Daniel's been afraid of animals or anything. He knows he's the bigger threat.
You're right, and he does like to show off. Maybe too much. You boys have been here over a month, and I still can't get over Daniel's skills.
Me neither, but I never figured it out, so I don't try anymore.
That kind of power is dangerous, Sean. He's a walking weapon.
Why does he look like David?
Never met someone with a superpower before.
I try to be a good influence.
Wait a second.
But he listens to me. Maybe I even fucked him up more.
Listen, raising a kid is the toughest job in the world.
Wait a second.
Combat was easier.
Oh my. It's fucking David, Chloe's step douche. It's her fucking stepdad. What?
Oh. You didn't tell me you were married.
I used to be. She died a few years ago.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. That's life.
Wow!
At least I got an angry stepdaughter in the deal. We were like oil and water, and she was always starting shit.
What?
Guess that's hard for a kid to get a new father.
Especially one like me. I just had no clue how to deal with her. Wish I did. But we eventually made our peace.
I didn't catch
anyway,
it at first when he said David.
Can't go back.
Nope. Thanks for talking, David.
Better start
wow.
out.
Look
Found
at that
some
shit.
Good snacks in town. Arthur's gonna freak.
Wow, look at David fucking.
Catch you later, Sean.
Calm down
okay.
a little. Seems he's
Time
not as much as an asshole.
I'm gonna melt. That was awesome, Mom.
Now I know why they don't play baseball in the desert.
You throw way better than Sean.
We're not done out here yet.
So Joyce died.
Let's get this food inside before it melts.
No problem.
That's a shame. I liked Joyce. She was awesome. Why'd she have to die?
She is so cool. You think?
Joanne is so cool. Stanley's so cool. The heat is so cool. You're way too easy, bro.
Whatever. Can't help it if I like Taryn.
Just be you and Anna. I'm just saying. Don't get too cozy here. This is a rest stop.
I know.
A peach stop. Is that weed on the counter?
That's smart that everybody takes turns shopping.
Mm-hmm.
So we just gonna leave them on the counter, I guess? Okay. Still gonna melt. And Daniel just saunters off.
I have to admit, I do miss that Pacific Northwest weather sometimes.
Yeah, I bet.
You've been here over a month now. What do you think of our little oasis?
It's a shithole. Everybody's cool.
Everybody's very cool and way different. Can't even believe nobody's freaking out about Daniel's power.
Well, Sean, it's still hard for me to wrap my head around it. But people here are not going to get in your space. They have their own past, too.
So my question
That's why people come here, from all over the country. For their own reasons. Not perfect, but it works.
What happens if we don't sacrifice Acadia Bay? Is Daniel still here? Or do somebody else come here? Like, maybe Max moves off the grid because she can't handle the fact that she had to sacrifice Chloe. I'm so confused.
It is so peaceful out here. Guess that's what everybody's really looking for. Peace.
You're probably right. Yes, I still feel like we're really privileged out here. There's bad shit going on in this desert.
Yeah. I don't think you can ever really get away from everything.
You can't escape reality. Even here. We just live slightly apart.
So, how did you end up here? This place is not on the map.
Like most of us, I was first brought here by someone, Maggie. After I failed to make it in New York, I was lucky enough to meet her down in Florida. She's had a tough life. This place was her getaway. She's long gone now, but her name is still written all over this place.
Well, thanks for bringing us here.
Are we talking literally or figuratively?
I'm glad I was able to help you. By the way, can you grab your evil little bro so we can all
talk? Is everything okay?
Yeah, I just thought we could spend this day together.
She's kicking
us out.
Just
the three of us.
She's gonna tell us we have to skedaddle.
Big brother to Super Wolf. We need you at Karen's trailer. Copy?
Sure. I mean, 10-4.
Copy that.
Hola.
Hola, compadre. How about a trek around the canyon today? You in?
Totally.
Let's pack then.